Okay. A pleasure to introduce Mr. Tibin Burgess, who is working in Reliance Retail Limited as HR of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Reliance Digital is a subsidiary of Reliance Industry, which is a multinational conglomerate company. Being an HR manager while taking the responsibility of two states is not that easy. What's your experience working for Reliance?
See, first of all, thank you so much for calling this meeting. See, for my experience in Reliance Digital is fantastic, because it is not easy to, as you said that, it is not easy to handle in both state. More than 1,000 people are there. So different culture, different people, lot of pressure will be there. Recruitment is the major part of our profile. So challenges will be there. Even though I could manage that, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, so wonderfully, we are establishing our stores in across Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So in a month, we are opening stores, within two stores will be opening in every month. So the establishment and the expansion is also going on. So good experience in the lines, because people are getting more opportunity, because you know that Reliance is acquiring more companies in nowadays. So also we have 250,000 employees working under Reliance Retail Limited. So in Reliance Digital, it is pan India level, 27,000 employees are working. So every day people are getting the opportunity inside the organization. So that is our experience.
Okay.
Sir, what do you look for when recruiting someone at your company?
No, I didn't get you. Can you repeat it?
Yes, sir. What do you look for when recruiting a candidate in your company?
Recruiting a candidate?
Yes, sir.
See, of course, first priority, the first parameter will be the qualification. So we have set in positions, and the parameters also we have set up for that particular positions. So suppose if I am hiring for a manager, minimum qualification required for that particular that position is degree. And the second thing is that the based on the performance, we'll be hiring the people for the right position. So it is not only for Reliance, every company is looking for a performance based hiring only. So before this scenario, maybe 5 to 10 years before, people were looking for education mark, how much percentage they have occurred in the degree or an MBA. Based on that only, the people are hired for the company. Nowadays, the scenario changed that every company is looking for a performance based candidate. If the candidate is performing very well in the interview, they will be hired for the particular profile. So we are also looking for who are performing in the interview will be hired for that particular position.
Sir, what qualities and attributes are required specifically to be an effective HR manager?
Of course, you should have a patience, because you are handling the profile which you need to have a lot of interaction with the people, and the people who you are meeting with different kind of attitude and behavior. That is a major challenge. You have to give an input to them, and you have to motivate sometimes the internal conflict will be there in the organization. You have to manage that situations also. Grievances will be there. So a lot of communication skills, the relationship where you are managing with the people also very important. And moreover, you will get a challenges, because recruitment is not a simple task where you are scheduling an interview for a particular position for 20-25 people, and where you can get the right candidate for only 2 or 3 people will be getting. That also will be challenging, that the salary is a barrier and the experience also is a barrier. So all these kind of things you have to look for when you are hiring for a candidate. And that's
okay. Your previous company was Future Groups, and now you are working for Reliance. Even though both the positions were HR, what major difference that you feel when working, moving from one organization to another? There will be certain differences, like the industries were different. How did you cope with all these situations?
See, both industries very different, because you know, future group is something different, culture is, you know, built up in this organization. Like, you know, you have to handle only one or two separate unit, and where you have, you know, 250, you know, 300 people will be there. Where you have to handle all the, you know, functions, like, you know, recruitment you have to handle, spare only you have to handle it, you know, training program is there, performance appraisal will be there. So you will be an all-in-all for the all the profile. So, and you know, people will be directly reporting to you. So here it is, you know, when it comes to Reliance Digital, where I am handling for, you know, area manager profile, and you know, I am handling, you know, 32 stores across, you know, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So we have an upcoming stores also, 3-4, you know, NSO stores also coming up. So that is a major challenge, you know. The culture also will be different, and you know, when you are, you know, coming to a different profile, you know, the responsibility will be more. So when it comes to, you know, recruitment, when it comes to, you know, the manager level of, you know, interaction and everything, where you are in working with, you know, future group, you know, we can handle, you know, 5 to 10 people manager level. Where it is come to, you know, Reliance Digital, we are handling with, you know, 30-35, you know, managers in one region. And if it comes to Tamil Nadu, I am handling, you know, 40-45, you know, manager level people. So that would be also different, and the culture also different in the, both organization.
Sir, how do you promote work diversity in the organization?
See, when it comes to diversity, you know, equal importance for, you know, each and everyone. It is not that, you know, particular, like, you know, male dominant organization or female dominant organization. So we are not providing equal important and equal opportunity for the, all the employees. So all the organizations are having, you know, that are, you know, diversity like male candidate. So in Reliance also, we are providing that, you know, opportunity for, and we are make sure that, you know, we are hiring, you know, male and female equally. There is no discrimination for gender discrimination or anything.
Okay, sir. As an HR manager, how will you drive results?
Pardon?
Sir? As an HR manager, how will you drive results?
Okay, see, basically, monitoring with, you know, people performance. And you have to ensure that, you know, when it comes to, you know, feedback from the, you know, different, you know, managers, you need to cross-check whether it is correct or not. Maybe people can give a, you know, wrong information also. So being an HR manager, being an HR person, every time, each and every time, when if in case of any kind of, you know, comment, any kind of feedback is coming from a particular, you know, manager, you need to cross check with that, you know, particular employee also. So you are, you know, responsible for, you know, hearing from the, you know, both level, employee side and, you know, manager level also. If it is a complaint also, you have to hear, you know, from the, you know, victim and, you know, witness also. So that is one thing you need to manage it.
So you have mentioned that there is no gender discrimination. But looking into the Reliance Digital, the major questions are handled by the men itself. And we can't see any women working in the higher positions in the sales areas or anywhere else like that. Why it's so?
Who said that? No, there is no female in the higher level. Operations is itself, you know, lady joined as a promoter and later.
So.
Hello.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, sir.
Okay. See, who told you that, you know, there is no lady dominant or no lady hiring is not there in the, you know, top level. See, my reporting manager itself is a woman. Okay, she's an Aram. No, she's taking care of Southwan region. And no, my second reporting is the South 3. I am taking care of both regions. So that also one lady is handling for the South 3 and 2. And when it comes to operation level, Aram operation is also a lady. She is taking care of South 1. And if it is when it comes to HR domain, like it is not like that. Woman is not leading the organization or leading the particular domain field.
Okay. Why the question is because while entering the stores, we can see only men's all over there, and there is no sales representatives of women. So that's why I'm asking like that.
Sir, how do you direct and?
No. In store level, see 20% is the woman ratio. 80-20. Let me answer this question. See, every unit we have a particular ratio. 80% when you go to any organization, 80% is that is a government rule. Labor rule is there. 20% you have to hire the female domain, and rest of the 80% you have to hire for the male. Whether it is irrespective of domain, you can check it.
Okay, sir.
Sir, how do you direct and derive the positive work environment, the organization or the workplace?
See, that is one thing, that is a major challenge for we are facing nowadays, because we cannot assure that work culture in a organization. One single person cannot ensure that working culture inside the organization. It is a teamwork. So as a team, you have to ensure that your team is in a particular or in a good atmosphere. We have to create that atmosphere inside the organization. So that is a major responsibility for a managers. So when you talk about a particular unit, there will be a department manager, store manager will be there. CRM manager will be there, commercial manager will be there. So all these people are leading the, that particular organization. Their major responsibility is that, make sure that, employees are coming for the organization for the work. They are, treating in a well manner, and that, atmosphere also they have to create inside the organization. So automatically we can, control the attrition also. When it comes to that an atmosphere good work culture inside the organization, people will never leave the organization. They'll stick on the organization for a longer period. As an HR also, it is my responsibility to that building culture is developing inside the organization, and we are keep on monitoring that whenever there is a complaint or whenever it's a concern raised from the particular unit, we'll be addressing and we'll be giving a quick response for that.
Sir, what are the methods adopted to the training programs of the employee?
Sorry, can you please repeat it?
Sir, what are the methods adopted to the training programs of the employee?
Okay, see, there is no particular training methods for the organization, we will be analyzing their performance. Every organization having different kind of training parameters. Training is majorly required for when it comes to performance level. When the employees are having issue with the performance, only the training is required. So moreover, we will be providing that additional skill acquisition programs will be there. We have a separate training team is there. So particular brand training is required. Every day, they are getting different kind of training program. Irrespective of their department training. So apart from that, I have required this kind of training, or I have required communication skill training program or behavioral training program. So they need to discuss with that their respective managers. They'll be taking up with HR team. So we'll be arranging with training team for the particular training program across Kerala and Tamil Nadu. That is purely depending upon the, you know, based on their, you know, performance level.
Okay. What is the hardest part about your profession, being an HR?
Of course, you know, hardest part is, you know, major challenge is, you know, recruitment only. You cannot, you know, fulfill the, you know, organization requirement in an immediate basis. As I said earlier also, when you come for, you know, recruitment program, there will be, you know, a number of vacancies, and you cannot fulfill that, you know, vacancies in a, within a span of period, because once you fill that, you know, profile, again another attrition will be coming, you know, from another side. It is a continuous circle. So it is rotating, like, you know, you will be, you know, filling one position and another position will be resigning from another side. Again, that, you know, recruitment cycle is continuing from everywhere. And the challenge will be there, of course, that the salary will be a challenge. No, required, no special experience, the domain also a challenge. That kind of challenges will be, of course, you know, the pressure, the tart will be also there, you know, for recruitment, you know, specific tart will be there. The turnaround time is there. So within a span of time also, you have to fulfill that, you know, positions and all. So that will be a major challenge. Apart from that, you know, there is no challenge. Once you get an experience, like, you know, continue with that, you know, flow.
How do you consolidate your HR strategies with other departments of your organizations?
I think your voice is not clear. Can you repeat it?
Okay, sir. How do you consolidate your HR strategies with other departments of your organization?
See, when it comes to HR strategies, you know, the best method which you can adopt, that, you know, build a good rapport with the team, whether it is, you know, operations or whether it is for marketing. Building a good rapport with the team is, you know, very important. So once it is, you know, you're creating good rapport with them, then you can easily, you know, you can implement the strategies without any difficulty.
Sir, as an HR manager, what is your view on job elimination?
Okay, do you mean termination?
Yes, sir.
Do you mean termination of the employee from the service?
As a job elimination, on your view.
Okay, see, it is a pure, you know, concept of, you know, performance only. No company will terminate the employee without any reason. Either it can be you know, kind of grievances, maybe it can be any kind of internal issue or theft. Such kind of cases only, you know, termination will happen. Unless and until there is no particular reason for that, you know, against that, you know, particular employee, that time only, you know, that, you know, termination process. In my viewpoint, that, you know, I will, like, you know, simple concern, like, you know, employees not, you know, coming to the store for, you know, particular 1 or 2 days, that, you know, we cannot, you know, initiate a termination. For that also, we have process, like, you know, we can give a, you know, verbal warning, we can give a warning letter. So such kind of process also inside the store. But certain cases where we have to implement, where you have to initiate the termination process, there, if it is a sexual harassment, or it is in a grievances, or it is in a theft cases, for those cases you have to initiate the termination employees to, otherwise, you know, it will be, you know, in continuation of that, you know, process, you know, in future also that, you know, person will repeat the same thing. So for that reason, you know, for a consent, we will be initiating the termination process only.
Sir, in your perspective,
what qualities? Okay. One thing where you have to give, you know, a lot of, you know, hard work in this profile. It is not like an easy, you know, profile HR. everyone is saying that HR is very easy, and you can go to the organization, you can, recruitment is very easy task, and training is very easy task, when it comes to payroll is very easy task. See, every profile having different kind of set of hard work, difficulty will be there. For HR domain, you need to have a lot of, as I said earlier, also patience is required, and you have to give a good kind of communication skill, and you have to build up with a good, important thing that you have to build up a relationship, because employee have to feel that anytime I can approach the HR for any kind of concern, and that is a one thing you need to develop and you need to understand. And apart from that, lot of skill acquisition you need to have, personality development, and people management also one thing you have to adopt it, because all these kind of things, it is one or two things only I am just mentioning that there are a number of matters you have to handle, because HR profile is multitasking profile. So at a time you will be handling many things, while I am taking interview also I am doing something in my system. So mail also we will be checking, and reply also we are giving, and partially we are doing some kind of activities in the system. And the analytical skill and the for the Excel knowledge also very important.
I think your audio is breaking.
Am I clear?
Yeah, now it's okay. Are you over then, sir?
Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yeah, sir.
Should I repeat it?
No, sir.
Should I repeat?
No, sir. It's clear, sir.
No, sir. Okay.
Sir, what are your strengths and weaknesses?
My strength and weaknesses?
Yes, sir. As an HR manager.
My weaknesses is I do not smoke and drink. That is my weakness.
Yes.
So my strength, I can handle any kind of situation. That is my major strength, and I can build up a good rapport with the team. So that is a major two important positive things in me.
How the recruitment and selection processes for the employees in your organization?
Okay. See, this is a similar kind of thing where you are layering the recruitment and selection process in the chapters. So a little bit of differences will be there, like employee how to apply for the positions, will be scrutiny the profile, where these people is apt for that particular positions. Once it is scrutinizing that profile, will be scheduling interview with that particular candidate. So they have to come for the interview, maybe 2-3 round will be interview will be there based on that particular positions. If it is a associate level, maybe store manager level interview will be there, and HR manager will be taking that final round of interview, it will be closing. And when it comes to manager level, there will be 2-3 round of interview will be there. So based on that interview will be, if it is that candidate is shortlisted for that particular position, then again will be HR will be talking to that particular person for the salary negotiation. If it is okay with that salary also, there will be examination called ARPAT examination will be, that is an aptitude test of test for that particular position. Then there is a personal behavioral test also will be there. We'll be analyzing that, whether this person is apt for that particular position. So where you can analyze that behavioral aspect. Certain behavioral aspect will be there in that particular test. So we'll be analyzing that PA test. Then of course that ARPAT test examination will be nowadays everywhere there. Even in your MBA colleges also, you have an initial stage of examination will be ARPAT only when it comes to interview process. So same thing, things will be happening in our organization also. Post that ARPAT examination only, employee will be onboarding. So that an onboarding stage itself, you know, there will be, you know, a lot of process will be there, you know, documentation and document verification will be there. All these kind of process will be, you know, completed, that employee will be onboarded in the organization. Employee code will be generated. So this is the one thing. And the, when it comes to selection process, so of course, you know, right candidate for the right profile is very much of important for, you know, every company. Even Reliance also looking for a right candidate for the, you know, right profile only. So that is a one major challenges for nowadays every company is facing. The quality people is not, you know, not getting for that, you know, particular positions. So that is a, you know, recruitment and selection process in my company.
Okay. So one last question. What advice that you want to give to BA students who are interested in specializing on HR?
Okay. See, for MBA students in HR, you will get an N number of, you know, feedback from, no, don't take HR field. HR is, no, you will be struggling to get a job opportunity in the market. Take it as a marketing or, you know, finance. There will be a number of, you know, opportunity will be there. See, HR or marketing or finance or operation, it is purely based on the, you know, performance only. If you have a good kind of skill set, if you have a good performer, definitely company will hire you. It is not like that, you know, HR people will not get the job, or marketing or, you know, finance people only will be getting the job. That is a, you know, wrong concept, you know, which, you know, people made it. So maybe you can ask your, you know, seniors also. Never they will suggest that, you know, go for HR. Because of course, you know, challenges will be there, but, you know, keep on stick on that, you know, particular, you know, specialization. When you are deciding for HR, you know, domain, go for it. Never change that, you know, decision, like, you know, if I am not getting the job also. So there will be opportunities. But, you know, initial stage, you know, little bit of struggling will be there. Once it is, you know, you have entered in an organization, keep on, you will be getting that, you know, opportunities. Even I specialized in HR and marketing also. That time also we faced that, you know, major challenges is that, you know, don't take HR profile, you will not get the job. That was the concept in that time also. In the period of 2013-15 time also, people are, you know, saying like that, HR domain is, you know, not getting the, you know, much job opportunity and all. But it is a purely wrong concept. And, you know, based on the, you know, skill set only, you know, people will hire you. If you are a good person, if you are a good communication, if you have, you know, good kind of, you know, skill set, definitely company will hire you. And when it comes to HR specialization, I am advising everyone that, you know, do not, you know, look for, you know, campus placement. Why don't you look for, you know, campus placement? Go for outside also. There are vacancies, you know, companies are hiring people. You can go to, you know, Infopark, you can go to, you know, Technopark, where companies are, you know, hiring people. They are, you know, looking for a fresh blood. But still we people are, you know, looking for only campus recruitment. But that is a major challenge for, you know, nowadays people are facing. And the quality of the people also nowadays is a major challenge. When it comes to, you know, recruitment, I've introduced in our college in the last time also, 120 people were attend for the interview, where I couldn't find out anyone for, you know, that, you know, particular position, what I have looking for. So, of course, you know, struggling will be there. And nowadays, you know, everything is in online platform. So, you know, the things will be, the companies also getting the struggling that, you know, right people or the quality people is not getting for the, you know, particular positions. So only thing is, you need to understand that, you know, market is, you know, very, you know, large perspective, and, you know, opportunities are there. Nowadays, competition also there, you know, not only for SP College or not only for Marine College is, you know, passing out MBA students. There are Kerala universities, Kannur universities, there are Calicut universities, and off-campus people also will be there. In outside, you know, market also people are studying MBA. Put together, you know, in a year, you know, 15,000-16,000 people are, you know, passing out MBA. So the market also, you know, bit of, you know, concern regarding that, you know, job opportunity. Like, you know, if you're good kind of, you know, skill set, you know, you can, you know, go for that, you know, particular, you know, domain. So don't think about that, you know, where will I get the job in future or not. Let it be complete the, you know, 2 years of course, then look for the job. And I'm advising you that, you know, do not wait for the, you know, campus placement. When it comes to the campus placement, go for it. But, you know, completely do not, you know, trust on campus placement. You know, campus placement is something different that, you know, where no college is arranging an opportunity only. That is a kind of lead only. So in when it comes to outside organization, when it comes to outside, you know, college also, companies are hiring people. Only, you know, thing is that, you know, you need to develop your, you know, certain skill set when it comes to communication and interaction and the relationship management, the kind of performance you are, you know, which performing in the interview panel. And that is also major one important things which you need to understand, which you need to develop it. So I'm sure that, you know, you people can grab it in the future for any, you know, opportunities. So go for it. HR is in a good profile and, you know, good domain. I'll suggest everyone, if I am saying that, you know, MBA students, you know, anyone can, you know, take the HR specialization instead of, you know, fearing about that, you know, specialization where I am taking HR and I will not get a job, not like that. Especially that is purely depending upon our, you know, individual, you know, performance level. No company will hire you that, you know, without any performer, you know, candidate. Fresh blood, I don't know, fresh performance only, you know, will be considered.
We are really thankful to you for joining us today. It was a wonderful experience. Wonderful words. Thank you so much, sir.
Apart from that, any kind of, you know, concern or questions you have, any queries, you can ask.
Okay, can I ask something?
Yeah, sure.
How do you feel recruiting students from campuses and recruiting an experienced person? What do you prefer most? Why freshers have less opportunities?
See, both are not different kind of, you know, profile. So for experienced candidate, only we are looking for, you know, that profile which we are, you know, having. That, you know, if I am having a, you know, store manager profile, I cannot, you know, put a one fresher candidate to that, you know, particular position, because that person is handling the entire store. So he required, you know, more experience to handle the team. So for fresher candidate, we'll be having a department manager training program, DMIT program is there. So we'll be hiring the, you know, fresher candidate for that, you know, particular profile. 6 months of, you know, training program will be there. We'll be evaluating their performance. We'll be, you know, giving a project program for that, you know, particular time period. Then again, we'll be reviewing their, you know, performance. So that period of time itself, you know, they can grab something from the organization. You know, they can observe, you know, many things that, you know, each and every department they will be going through that, you know, how these things are, you know, happening inside the store, how, you know, people are managing the department. So that kind of experience they'll be learning. If I am putting that, you know, particular person to, you know, store manager level, so maybe, you know, their subordinate may be having, you know, good kind of experience. Maybe that person cannot, you know, manage that the entire team. Maybe 25 to, you know, 230 people will be there in the one single store. So a fresher, you know, instead of a fresher putting in that, you know, store, I can put a experienced candidate from the, you know, from the organization, from any outside organization. So he can also manage that, you know, people without any kind of, you know, challenges. So that is a difference. So, you know, both profile is having, you know, both, you know, requirement. Yeah.
Yes, I want to ask something else.
Okay. See, be positive. Like, you know, HR domain is always in a good profile. All of you can, you know, pursue your career in HR. You know, there are not many vacancies and there are not many opportunities, you know, coming up in HR. It is not like that. Initially, we will be struggling period for everyone. Even I have also not struggled a lot of in the initial period. So the thing is that, you know, there is a one term called as, you know, hard work, and, you know, we people are always looking for, you know, in a peaceful, you know, atmosphere for working. So do not, you know, expect that, you know, the industry peaceful or no comfortable situation in anywhere. So expect that, you know, struggling will be there. So you have to face that, you know, struggling. So then only you can able to handle the both situation. So if you are now working in a comfortable situation or in a good atmosphere, you know, always, when it comes to struggling period, you cannot manage that situation. So if you are initially you are struggling with lot of problems and all, you can easily manage that struggling time also. If you can manage also that comfortable situation also, both situation you can manage easily. So that is one thing which I can give an advice. And certain things you need to work upon, like Excel management and the communication skill that, and certain HR related articles, the latest communications which you can also refer it. Of course, when you go for an interview, please refer all these kind of things, because it is very important when you are specializing in an HR domain. You need to go through all these kind of things. You need to have a knowledge in that particular area. Of course, PF, maternity, bonus, companies act, and what kind of latest amendments are coming in the HR domain. All these kind of, you need to update it. So that will be an added advantage once you go for an interview. Am I clear? Your doubts and then your question answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you for finding time for us.
Okay. Thank you so much. So if in case of any doubt or any queries, keep in touch. So you can attend anytime, you can contact.
Okay. Thank you.